Hello, salamat datang kembali untuk Rex Peru. My name's Mike, and I'm a classically trained violinist here in Canada, and I like to do reaction videos. So today we're going to check out Ali Bata and his rendition of Dialova by Onche. I hope I'm saying that right, Onche. So this week, just for fun, I did a poll to see what people wanted to see most for the next reaction. And I think there was about 1,600 votes, which is a lot of votes. By far, this was the most popular one. So I'm really excited to hear this one. Oh, and before we get into the song, guys, I want to let you guys know I'm really excited. I've got about 800 words, Indonesian words. So I'm just slowly learning new words. So this song actually has like an interesting history, and it's got a lot of interesting things about it that I want to talk about before we listen to the song. So Onche is the name of the singer, and he was the lead singer of an Indonesian band called Dewa 19. While he was the lead singer of Dewa 19, like from 2000 and on, he had three singles, and this was one of them. And he had two other singles, Symphony Yang Indah and Aku Mau. And so this song came out in 2005, and it was off of a soundtrack of a movie that was called Dialova. I actually, I watched part of the movie. I'll leave a link for you guys if you want to watch the movie on YouTube. It's like a kind of a teenage romance movie about a girl that falls in love with two guys, and she kind of has to choose between the two. I didn't watch a lot of it. It's not really my type of movie, but yeah, if you're interested in like romantic type movies, you should check it out. The interesting thing about this song is that it wasn't written by the singer Onche. It was actually written by Opik. And the interesting thing about Opik is he's a religious songwriter. He's a Islamic songwriter and singer. When you hear the song and you watch the movie, you don't really think of it as a religious song. It sounds more like kind of like a love song. So even though the lyrics are the same, there's kind of two different versions of this song. And what's interesting is Opik actually released his own version of Dialova in 2012. Very similar, but it sounds a lot more like reflective and a lot more maybe religious or spiritual. So I'll leave the lyrics for you guys to read down below in the comment section, because It's kind of interesting. Even though both versions have the same lyrics, they seem to have different interpretations. It seems like the song can be about being in love with somebody, or perhaps the song can be a reflection and love for God, which seems to be the Opik version. And I'm curious how Ali Bata is gonna play it. So let's check it out. This is a beautiful song. This is gonna sound great. So that introduction to the song, in the original, there's like a symphony, there's string players and that sort of thing. So he's trying to make it sound like the orchestra, trying to bring out those orchestral instruments, like the strings. It sounds already kind of more like the Opik version, I think. It has more of a thoughtful, spiritual quality to it. How he uses his like artificial harmonics, and he uses his extended techniques, but it's done in a really tasteful way. It's just used to like do the song justice. It's not used to show off or this kind of thing. I really like that. I love how he's using his pinky as percussion. That's a really nice touch to it. Mm-hmm. sorry, we're going to get to the chorus. This is a really beautiful chorus. This chorus like gives me goosebumps every time I hear it. I love it. Beautiful phrasing in this one, like really, really nice shifting. I love those really smooth shifts. This is like really tasteful, really tastefully done. This song kind of reminds me of Tom Hee Ho a little bit. It's also in a minor key, which makes it sound a little bit more mysterious. But this one, it's in a 3/4 time signature, so. This song is in that 3/4 time signature, so 1 2 3 1 2 3. It's like a waltz, which is, it's like a style of dance where you dance with your partner, and it can be a bit of a romantic dance, I think. This is so good. This is so good. The phrasing, like the musicality in this one, is so good. I love it. I love it. Man, that was a great recommendation, guys. Thanks a lot for recommending that. That was a really great performance. I think this will be a good one to add violin for. I know I say that for like every video, but this one actually I think would be a lot of fun. I think this would be a really good one. Maybe for next week I'll do another poll to see what you guys want me to listen to for a new reaction. I guess we have maybe one more week left before the end of 2020. So yeah, I look forward to making more videos in the new year, and wish you guys all a happy new year. Hopefully it'll be a lot better than this 2020. It was kind of a rough year for a lot of us. I think now with the vaccine coming, and I think things will get better in 2021. So I hope you guys are all staying safe, and I hope you guys are all doing well. I think things are starting to look hopeful now, so hopefully we'll have a good year next year in 2021. So guys, as always, I really, really appreciate your guys' support. You guys are really awesome. If you guys like this video, please like, comment, subscribe if you can, and I'll see you for the next one.